In order to do this particular problem, we have to get the absolute value part all by itself. If they give it to us just like they do in this example, then we're fine. But because absolute value just means how far away from zero it is, then what's inside of it could be either negative 10 or 10, because both of those numbers are 10 units away from zero. So if you have the absolute value equals a negative number, that's no solution. So that you just can't have a negative distance. So if you see a negative number over here and only the absolute value, there'll be no solution. So in this case, 2x plus 4 could be 10 or negative 10, and then we just solve for x. And we have two solutions that we can give. So on this one, 4 is positive, so we know that 4x minus 12 can be both positive 4 and negative 4. So 4x minus 12 can equal 4, or 4x minus 12 can equal negative 4. Now you have to write both of them, because when you solve, you're going to get two different answers. So we'll just solve the first one first. So we're going to add 12 plus 4 is 16. 4x equals 16. Divide by 4, so x is 4. When we add 12 to this one, you have to do a negative 4 plus 12, which is 8. So then x could be 2. So we'll list our solutions as 2 and 4. I like to put the smallest number first, but it shouldn't matter what order you put it in. Okay, the next one. This is a negative 5. As soon as you see that negative, just hit no solution. There's no way absolute value can be negative. Those ones are, I think, a lot easier, because then you don't solve for anything. Now, when you have zero there, that's cool, because there's only one solution. 2w plus 14 can only be zero, because there's no such thing as a negative zero. So we're just going to set it equal to zero and subtract 14. Zero minus 14 is negative 14. When we divide by 2, w will be negative 7. It's okay that w is negative 7, because the absolute value when w is negative 7 is still 0. So that's the end of the lesson. Whoops, I hit next.